almost over. The Battle of the Champions is about to take place with Phil Taylor, the WDC World Champion and the standard bearer of that organization, out to prove for once and for all that he is the best in the business, bar none. To do that, he must beat the former BDO world champion Richie Burnett in a contest that for so long has seemed just an impossible dream. Also tonight, five times undisputed world champion Eric Bristow will be reenacting those great clashes of the 70s against an arch rival. The former World Masters champion, Welshman Alan Evans, rivaled Bristow as one of the game's great crowd pleasers. And first, Dennis Priestley, a dual former world champion, a star and stalwart of the WDC, the Mexborough marksman, is one of the game's all-time greats.
He is the rightful world champion, and surely nobody, but nobody, will argue with that.
Tonight, Priestley meets another former BDO world champion, Canada's John Parr, in the first of tonight's Battles of the Champions. Six of the very best on the same stage at last.
Applause, ladies and gentlemen. Come on, let's go!
Hello, welcome to the home of World Darts, the Circus Tavern in Purfleet, which tonight stages the Battle of the Champions. And a full house here in anticipation of a very special evening indeed. No money will exchange hands here tonight. They're playing for a far more valuable commodity this evening. Pride takes pride of place. The acrimonious split between the two governing bodies has prevented players being at the same venue, let alone on the same hockey, in recent years. Tonight, that changes. Tonight, we find out who really is the best in the world. This is our order of play this evening. Three very special contests indeed. Dennis Priestley and John Part kick us off. Dual world champion Dennis Priestley, former BDO world champion John Part, two of the greats of the 70s, and in Eric Bristow's case, the 80s as well. Eric Bristow takes on Alan Evans. And then the climax of the night's action, the undisputed, the world champion Phil Taylor. Most people believe the finest player in the world, but you would get a major argument about that from the former BDO world champion, Richie Burnett. This is the Battle of the Champions. That is what it's all about. It's an occasion that we suspected would not happen, but it is, and it will tonight, and Sid Waddell is alongside me, and he's licking his lips. Gonna be plenty of pressure on the boys tonight, isn't there? I mean, Philip.
The bunch of people who think he is the best player to ever walk the earth. Bristow was. Bristow used to win some things. Luckily, was the night against Evans.
I think Taylor is not yet at his peak. I think on form, he should win against Burnett. Burnett is a flair player like Evans, like Bristow. But I don't think he's actually rubbed shoulders with enough hot cats in darts to handle Taylor. I think Taylor, who's won about 100,000 quid in the last 6 months, is now nearing his peak. And now Richie's a hell of a scorer. I'm not quite sure that he can handle him, but it will be a tremendous game.
That's the highlight of a marvellous night. Before that, we have some real nostalgia, don't we, with Bristow against Evans. It takes us right back to the 70s and some of the contests they had then.
Absolutely. I first seen Alan Evans in 1972 at the Indoor League when he scored 180 against another great Welsh player, Tony Riddler. He sets the game alight. He's the Dennis Law of the game, whereas Brissy's more like the Tommy Smith, the crippler. They used to have amazing games in 79, and Alan was fined 250 quid for bringing the game into disrepute for remarks after a little bit of a, let's say it was a rumble, a bit of gamesmanship against Eric. Look out for the flash. But one nice thing is that, and this is a celebratory night for darts, they've been practicing together. So the big clashes and sometimes gestures, I think, of the 80s, early 80s, late 70s, will be there, but they'll be caricatured tonight. I think they'll both work the crowd. And as for the other match, I think we could be in for a bit of Yorkshire pain there. I think Part is one of the best counters in the game. And if Dennis has got a weakness, it's his combination counting. And Pard got 55% of his finishes when he won the World Championship in the final, despite six darts, I think, at his last double. So Pard is a very good finisher. He's also got the honour of being the only overseas guy ever to take the world title away. So I think we're going to start with a belter.
Well, that is the first match. As Sid said, it's going to be quite an encounter at the start of what could be a very special night indeed. Sit back now and enjoy the first match, Dennis Priestley and John Pard. Let's meet our MC now, Phil Jones.